Hello everyone. In this module, I'm going to demonstrate how to call Apex class methods in Aura components. So let's jump into developer console. So in this demonstration, we need to implement two things. One is Aura component and another one is controller, Apex controller. So Apex controller will be part of server and Aura component like will be part of client side. So we need to fetch the data of S object through Apex controller. So let's first create Apex controller. So I'm naming it as account controller. So whenever you create any Apex class that you will be linking with your Aura component. So if you implement any method in that class, and if you are calling that method in the Aura component, so you need to use one annotation that is Aura enabled. If method is Aura enabled, then only they will be called in the Aura component, otherwise not. Then public static void, not void, list of account. So it will be returning list of account and naming it as get accounts, right? Then I'm creating list of account, ACC list equals to new list of account. Then ACC list equals to select ID, name from account and limit 10. So this is the where clause, like not where clause, it is a limit. So only 10 records will be queried and they will be available in this ACC list. And after that, I am writing return ACC list. Right, so this way I implemented this account controller, which is basically Apex controller. And this Apex controller we can call in the Aura component. So whatever value it will be returning, so we can render those values in the Aura component, or we can use these values for any calculation in the Aura component. So now I'm going to create new Lightning component and naming it as account LC, account Lightning component, and clicking on submit. Now in this component, we need to create the view of this Lightning component, like what should be rendered on the UI. So first I'm creating one attribute. Its name will be ACC list and type will be list. So in one of the previous module, I demonstrated like how we can create list. So here we are creating list, its name will be ACC list. Then Aura handler name init. So init also we used in previous modules. Then in this init, we need to provide value and action. So action is C dot doing it. So this is a handler. Whenever component loads, this handler automatically calls a method which is available in this action. So we need to define this doing it function so that whatever task you want to perform on load of this component can be executed. Now after this, I'm creating Lightning select. So this will be a dropdown. So where you can select particular value. So naming it as select one, labeling it as select an account. Right, inside this Lightning select, I need to provide some options. So first option will be none. So value of this will be null. And label will be displayed as none. Now, this ACC list is a list which will contain more than one account records, right? So we need to iterate on this. So in this module, first time we will be using iteration in Aura component. So if you want to apply iteration in Aura component, so you need to use Aura colon iteration, then items equals to, and here you can pass that list. So you need to use V exclamation V dot ACC list. So here it is known as collection, and to iterate it one by one. So we need to create this variable as well. So it is kind of for each. So we are iterating on this ACC list with the help of this items equals to, and one by one, each account will be available in this item. So now we need to use this item. So here I'm writing option value equals to item dot ID, because through this controller, we are receiving ID and name. So those will be available here as well. So item dot ID, closing this, and here item dot name. So item dot name will be a label. And if you select that particular item or like name, account name, so for internal process, its ID will be used. So this is the idea behind this. Now, removing these spaces, saving this code, right? So this way I implemented this UI part. So a dropdown will be available where multiple account records will be rendered. And if you select particular account, so that account's ID will be used as a value for further calculations, right? So now we need to define doInit function so that onload whatever default operation we want to perform that can be executed. So default operation, what we need to do, like we need to link that Apex controller so that we can call that method. So now we need to do one more thing in this component. So here I need to write controller equals to account controller. So now if you want to link this Apex controller with your Lightning component, so you need to write this statement. If you write this statement, then only you will be able to call the methods which are available in this class. So why it is showing, okay, so name is incorrect. Now it is perfectly fine and it is saved, right? So I hope you understood how we can link Lightning component with this Apex controller. So you need to remember this. If it is not mentioned here, so it is like a runtime error. So you will be debugging your code and it is difficult to find, like you forgot to write this. So in initial like implementation, you need to write this so that you won't put yourself in trouble, right? So let's now implement the controller part so that we can have the doInit implementation. So I'm clicking on this controller, renaming it as doInit. And here we need to call the method of that account controller class. So creating one variable named as action, component.get. Now in double quotes, you need to write c.getAccounts. So remember, here we use this C dot to call functions of this JavaScript controller with exclamation sign. But in this controller, if you want to call Apex controller methods, Apex controller means like this account controller. If you want to call this getAccounts method, so then also you need to use this C dot, but here exclamation is not required. So we are calling C dot getAccounts. Now action dot set callback this comma function response. So response will be available in this response parameter. So here I'm writing variable state equals to response.getState. And then if state triple equals to success. So if you are successfully able to call that method and you received some response, so this if condition will be true. So now the result is available in this response, and we need to store that result into this ACC list that we created here. So how we can do that? So we need to write component.set v.acc list and response.get return value. Right, so this way the returned value will be assigned into this ACC list, and we are returning a count list, so it will be automatically stored in this. And here we need to end it. Now we need to use one more statement, $a.nqAction and action. So this is a global action, and if you don't write this, then this complete action won't be executed, right? So what we did, first we called this method, which is part of that Apex controller. Its information will be available into action. We are attaching, or like we are calling set callback method, and we are doing this operation, and then we are passing this action into this NQ action. So all together it will be executed, and the result will be available on the UI so that you can execute that. So I hope you understood how I implemented all these things. So I implemented three things. First is Apex controller, second components view, and then components controller. Now I'm going to open a demo application so that we can render this. So account lightning component we need to render. So I'm saving this, clicking on preview. So it's loading. So here you can see select an account message is available. Initially it is showing none. And if I click here, so it is showing 10 accounts name. So names are available as a label. If I select any account, so internally its ID will be automatically selected here. And this you can use for further calculation. So this way I demonstrated you like how we can link our Apex controller with the Lightning component. And now whatever changes you make in this Apex controller, that will automatically reflect to your Lightning component. So let's say if I change it to 5, and if I don't make any change in the Lightning component, so it will be available with your component. So only 5 accounts are displayed, right? So controller is available at server side. It is interacting with your S object. It will return the values, and accordingly you can do processing on your data. So I hope this way you understood like how we can call Apex class methods. So this way we can connect Apex controller with Lightning component, which is implemented using Aura. So this is all about how to call Apex class methods. Thank you.